Yo, KP Sky here. What's going on, YouTube? What's in front of you right now is a Samsung 7 Series in-use 7300, a 55-inch 4K curved television. Now, it's not going in the living room. It's not replacing my OLED whatsoever. It's actually going to go in the bedroom, replacing my older Samsung. So what do you say we get this thing unboxed, let's get it unpacked, and let's talk about it. Now, before we get started, I'm actually selling this older Samsung right here on eBay right now. I believe you have about 2 days or so. It's on bid right now for 105, or you can buy it right now for 300. So guys, if you're interested in this TV here, this Samsung 48-inch 4K TV that I've reviewed a couple times on this channel, if you're interested in this television, head over to eBay, type in Samsung JS8500. My TV will pop up. You guys can bid on it for $105, $110, whatever you want, or you can buy it outright for $300. So if you need a TV right now, definitely check that out.
You may press the right button to set up the TV with the TV remote.
Alright guys, so this is the Samsung in-use 7300. Nice curved TV. Now let me explain why I got this television. I didn't look for anything, you know, too serious, too big. I do have my LG OLED in the living room. I wasn't looking to do too much in this room. I actually stumbled upon this at Walmart for $548 right now. Walmart $548. That's the cheapest across the market. Best Buy, Amazon, eBay, you can't find it cheaper anywhere other than Walmart, as far as I know, as of this recording. So I stared at this TV for maybe 30 minutes to an hour every day for the last week and contemplated, should I get this television or not? And I obviously pulled the plug on it because, again, I just want something simple. Something simplistic, didn't need too much in this room because most of my viewing is going to be in the main theater. This TV is just going to be used for YouTube, maybe a couple of videos on Amazon Prime, things like that, so I didn't need anything crazy. Now, I do have a couple complaints about the television right off the bat. Number one being the way they use their mounting brackets. If you want to mount your television on a wall or on a stand like I have down here, you're actually going to need to buy other parts to do so. You have to call Samsung, it's in their manual, you have to call Samsung and get the number so that you can order your mounting kit so that you can mount it on the wall or on a stand like I have here. Luckily, since I already had my stand, I had the screws that were necessary to mount my TV, so I got lucky there. But if you do buy this television, you do have to get mounting kits from Samsung, just more money out of your pocket. Now, this is Samsung's budget kind of television. It's not gonna have the rich features of some of their higher end TVs, but it's a good middle class, middle of the road television. So you're gonna get your 4K, you're gonna get your HDR 10 Plus, which is supposed to rival Dolby Vision, which I'm really curious to find out because this is my first HDR 10 television and my LG is a Dolby Vision, so we may have to go head-to-head and see how those work. Now this is a bottom lit LED screen, so all the LEDs are recessed on the bottom here and they shine up. So there's no actual local dimming or anything like that, but being an edge-lit TV, you don't have a lot of ghosting or stuff like that when you have brights over here and darks over here. It kind of evens itself out that way, but again, there's no local dimming, but that's going to be okay. It's still a 4K HDR 10 TV, so I'm super happy with it already. It has a very nice looking finish, but mind you, the entire backside is plastic. It's not a brushed metal finished like the rest of their TVs, the higher end TVs, the QLEDs, the 8 series, the 9 series. You're not going to get that nice of a finish, and it's rather thick for a television from Samsung. We all know nowadays televisions are getting razor thin, just as thin or thinner than your phone. This TV is a little bit thick, but not unattractive, I would say. It looks really, really nice. Black all the way around the front and the back. It's made of a hard plastic on the front, and then even lighter plastic on the back. So that's where they're cutting costs at. That's why this TV's $548. You're not gonna get the quality finish. You're not gonna get the Dolby Vision. You're not gonna get the Dolby Atmos encoding. Not with this television, not with this set. This is gonna be the remote that it comes with. Of course, being a budget TV, you're gonna get a budget remote. So it's made of complete plastic, really light in the hand. And you can see it's just congested with buttons. You have button layouts here, down here, all through here, and you may or may not use any of these more than once after you set your television up. But it's a basic remote, no LED backlight, but it's going to do everything you need it to do. There's no hotkeys on here, so you're not going to be able to go straight to Netflix, straight to Amazon, straight to YouTube or Vudu like most remotes have. And you're also not going to be able to use this as a magic remote. Now, the one thing I will miss is the magic remote from my old TV. I was able to just move my hand around and the TV would follow me. But with this, you're going to have to go back to the standard buttons with no backlight. Now, I'm not going to review this TV in this video, especially because I haven't actually watched anything or used it yet. So there's not too much I can tell you guys about this yet. So be sure to stay tuned for a later video, probably next week or maybe this weekend, of this television, what I think about it. Let me get some usage, let me calibrate it, get the colors, the sharpness, and everything right, make it as best as it can be, and then tell you what I think about it. Of course, I have read my review, so I already know a good basis of what this TV can and cannot do, but I'm gonna use it here in my application and see if it does what I need it to do for me. So guys, make sure you guys stay tuned for that video because it's gonna be a good one in case you're looking for this TV. And if you haven't heard this TV, maybe it's a good one for you. Who knows? Again, guys, I am selling this TV here, the Samsung JS48-8500 on eBay right now. So if you guys are looking for a television that's not too big in size, maybe for a bedroom or a smaller apartment, this TV is going to work for you. The description and everything about it is on eBay in the description list. So if you guys are looking for a television right now, maybe just to use as a smart TV, watch Netflix, YouTube, this may be a television for you. Right now, there's a bid for $105, but if you want this TV just outright, you can pay $300 for you and I will send it straight to you via UPS. Probably about 4 or 5 days to get it, depending on where you are in the United States. Only United States I'm gonna ship it to you because overseas or Canada, it takes a lot of money to ship things of this weight. But guys, if you're interested in this television, you guys seen my videos, you can see any video you want about it, its usage, how I've used it, what I've done with it, gaming, what I've watched on it. You guys get all the details there. So message me if you want some more questions answered or any pictures at all. But there are some descriptions and pictures on eBay, so check that out. Just type in Samsung UNJS8500. I'm the only one selling this TV on eBay, so you're gonna find me pretty quickly. So guys, again, if you guys need a TV or you just want a TV for maybe a playroom or something like that, this may be the TV for you. Alright guys, so that's going to do it for this video. Make sure to stay tuned for my review of this TV. It may be in a bang for your buck video, because if it's as good as I think it'll be, I might put it in that series. So stay tuned for that, guys. I appreciate you guys watching. Stay tuned for the review. Stay tuned on Friday, because we're going to do another episode of Sub Showcase, where we show off more home theaters for my subscribers. So guys, take care. Keep my comments. Hit the like button and hit that subscribe button as well. And we'll see you in the next video. K-Base Guy out.